Hey scientist, isn't it beautiful out here? I decided to take a little trip to the ocean to learn more about animals. And what's that? There's something behind me? Is that a shark? Oh, phew! It's not a shark. It's a dolphin. Their dorsal fins look an awful lot alike sticking out of the water, but they are actually very different animals. But if they both live in water, why aren't they the same? I wonder, how are sharks and dolphins different? Let's dive in and find out. Let's think about what we know about sharks and dolphins. Well, both of them live in the water. That must mean they are the same class of animal, right? Not necessarily. We have to look at all of the characteristics that help us to classify animals to know where the dolphin and shark belong. Remember, good scientists always test their hypotheses. My hypothesis is that because they both live in the water, sharks and dolphins are from the same class of animals. As we learn more about both sharks and dolphins, we can use the Venn diagram in our guided notes to help us keep track of things that are the same and different about these two animals. To start, we already know that they both live in the water. What are some other things you observe about dolphins and sharks that are the same? They both have fins, and they both need to swim in order to get around. Pause the video here to add these similarities to the middle of your Venn diagram. None of the things we've listed so far have to do with the characteristics we learned about when we were classifying mammals. Let's think. One of the classifications of animals had to do with how the animals were born. Remember, there are two different options, live birth and laying eggs. Dolphins and some sharks give live birth. But sharks are an interesting animal, because while about half of sharks give live birth, the other half lay eggs. We need to add that to the Venn diagram. Does this knowledge help us decide what classification sharks and dolphins are? Well, since both types of animals are able to give live birth, I think we can safely say that dolphins and sharks are not birds, because birds only lay eggs. We've noticed a lot of similarities between sharks and dolphins, but there are a lot of differences too. For example, dolphins are warm-blooded creatures, while sharks are cold-blooded creatures. Some sea creatures like dolphins, whales, and porpoises are warm-blooded animals. They have something called blubber, which is a thick layer of fat that allows these underwater animals to stay warm even in very cold water. Kind of like how we might wear a puffy jacket when it's cold outside. Sharks, on the other hand, don't have blubber. Instead, their body adapts by matching the temperature of the water around them. This is what makes a shark a cold-blooded creature. Pause here and add this information to your Venn diagram. That's not the only major difference between sharks and dolphins, though. We already learned that some animals breathe underwater using gills. As water flows over the gills, they work to pull the oxygen out of the water and give it to the animal. Sharks have gills that allow them to live underneath the water at all times. Dolphins, however, do not have gills. You might be wondering, if they don't have gills, how can they breathe underwater? Well, the answer is, they can't. Dolphins have something called a blowhole. A hole in their head that works just like nostrils do in a human nose. They must come to the surface of the water so their blowhole can pull air into their bodies, and then they store that air inside their lungs so they can remain below the surface of the water for longer. Wait! Live birth, warm-blooded, and lungs? Dolphins are sounding an awful lot like mammals. Let's compare the rest of the characteristics of mammals to a dolphin. I know that all mammals have hair or fur on their bodies, but a dolphin is looking pretty smooth. That's because only baby dolphins have hair. When it is born, a baby dolphin has hair around its mouth, sort of like whiskers on a cat. However, as the dolphin grows, the hair falls off, leaving their skin super smooth. Dolphins also feed milk to their young. And look, they even have those special teeth that mammals are known to have. That can only mean one thing. A dolphin is a mammal. So interesting. But wait, a shark can't be a mammal because they're cold-blooded and sometimes lay eggs. So let's look at what a shark can be. We already discussed that a shark cannot be a mammal or a bird. So that leaves us with three more options: reptiles, amphibians, and fish. Look at this close-up picture of a shark. What do you notice? That's right. Sharks don't have hair on their bodies. They have scales. Scales are a characteristic that can be found on both reptiles and fish. But amphibians don't have scales, so a shark is not an amphibian. Remember how we said some sharks give birth and some lay eggs? Reptiles and fish are able to reproduce in both ways, so that doesn't help us narrow it down. Add what you've learned so far about sharks to your Venn diagram. Wait, I see here on the Venn diagram that sharks have gills. Reptiles don't use gills. They have lungs they use to help them breathe. So a shark can't be a reptile, which means... that's it! A shark is classified as a fish! Whoa! So even though they are both sea creatures, sharks and dolphins have a lot of differences. In fact, scientists even classify them differently. A shark is a fish, while a dolphin is a mammal. Not all animals that you find in the water are fish, but many of them are. That's because all fish live in the water, and they are the only animal class that can live underwater without ever having to come up for air. Wow! The next time you see a creature in the water, will you remember how to tell if it's a mammal or a fish? Keep observing, scientists. Remember, science is all around you. Hey.